Good afternoon and welcome to Have a Chat. It is a very rainy, rainy Monday afternoon, but here we are back with you again. And of course, my name is Véronique Garcineau and I am so pleased to be your host today, alongside with my fantastic co-hostess, Judy Loche.
Nothing but us both being in black. Are
I know.
Feeling drab on this Monday or something?
It's true. I was feeling a little bit of it today.
I had a sundress out.
Did you?
To wear, and I thought, oh, it's going to be okay, warm and muggy. And I walked out, it started to rain on me. I went in and put a sweater on.
No, I know.
But we'll take it. We'll take it.
Well, there's nothing we can do about it.
No.
But Audrey couldn't be with us today. She had some stuff going on that she had
that's
to take care of. And
just
so
you and I?
It is.
All right. That's okay. We work well together.
We're good together. So I'm going to kick it off with my quote of the day.
All right. Which I have not heard.
Yes. I have the quote today. So it's actually by Morgan Freeman.
I love him.
I know. And I just love what he has to say usually. So this spoke to me this morning when I went looking for it. With everything that kind of happened over the weekend, the end of the Olympics and the tragically hip that we're going to talk about, it really, it spoke to my heart.
Okay.
I know it sounds a little gooey.
No, it resonated with you.
I'm okay with gooey today.
All right.
So Morgan Freeman. So how do we change the world? One random act of kindness at a time.
That's so true, Véronique.
Yeah.
If everybody just did one act of kindness, it would spread.
It's true.
It would be a contagious effect and the world would be a better place. But
well, we all think that, you know, that we can't affect change because we can't do the grand gesture. We can't, you know, save the world. But you know what? Maybe you're saving the world for somebody today.
Do you know a smile can change somebody's
That's
outlook?
True.
They can, right. It can make or break somebody's day?
Yes, for
or
sure.
Or she smiled at me and I felt so unimportant, so now I feel, you know, like worthwhile that she even gave me your attention.
It's true.
I know, I know, and I've heard that from people.
Yeah.
Like your smile brightened my day or your kind word, you know, hello, in a nice, friendly manner made them feel better.
Yeah, and actually that happened to me last week. A dear friend of mine, I hadn't seen him in a long, long time, and we ran into each other in a business meeting. And the next day he sent me a text randomly. And he said, you know what? He said, just know that you can do anything.
I love it.
And
it
I was just
makes
like,
you feel
oh my goodness.
So good. Or when someone says you're special to me and you know you're a wonderful person, you know, you don't even think that they thought that until they say it, and then you feel so much better.
Yeah, yeah. So yeah, one random act
of
kindness.
Very, very nice. So did you have a thought? We sometimes have these fun moments, thought-provoking questions because, you know, we like to be on the spur of the moment type of girls.
Yes.
So what's your question for me here?
All right. Well, I had three to pick from this morning, but
it's a good, kind one.
I'm gonna do this one. So when was the last time you tried something new?
Last night.
Woo! Yay, Judy! Am I going to ask you what it was?
No. Oh, my God. Well, anyway, the trapeze broke.
Oh, darn. I hate when that happens.
I know. They're hard to replace and hard to put up.
You're right.
You know?
Yep.
Let me think. The last time I tried something new was probably perfume.
Okay.
And I tried one by Stella McCartney.
Oh, yes.
And it's Stella. Mm-hmm. There's a dark one and a light one, and I fell madly in love with the scent. People were up smelling my wrists, smelling my neck. You know, keep away, folks. Keep away. It's divine. So
really?
Stella McCartney. So now I keep a little thing in my purse. It's just a roll-on. I don't have it on today.
Yep.
But it's fantastic. So that's the last thing I tried that was new.
Okay, I'll have to take a little smell away.
Besides last night.
Good for you. Good for you,
okay,
Judy.
Okay, my question for you, Véronique, is if you could be either, would you rather be super intelligent and extremely unattractive, or beautiful, beautiful, and dumb as a post?
Oh, no. That's a tough one.
It is, but think about it.
Brilliant
and homely, or dropped in
gorgeous. Okay, I know. Okay, so I would choose brilliant simply because if I were brilliant, I could, you know, save the world, make a ton of money, and then buy myself some really good clothing and some makeup
and a mask,
you know, and then you know what? I would be beautiful to someone who would love me.
That's right. There's somebody for everybody.
That's right.
And beauty is on the inside.
That's right.
And somebody told me yesterday a quote that your father actually said, and I thought it was awesome. They said that Roger Arsenault, Véronique's dad, made the most wonderful comment one time. She was looking at something that she thought was really unappealing. He said, ugly is in the eye of the beholder.
It's true.
Rather than beauty.
It's true.
I've never heard that before.
You're right.
Ugly is in the eye of the beholder. So you might say, what an ugly looking flower. What the heck's that? And I'll say, that is magnificent.
Yeah, you're right.
So,
yep.
Good
somebody,
for your father
somebody would love me.
That.
Somebody would love me.
Okay. So
somebody would love me, and I could save the world at the same time.
Yeah, we could put you on the show with all your brilliance and turn your back
That's
to the wall.
Right. That's okay. I'm okay with that, because I would be fabulous.
All right. So you watched the Olympics, no question.
Oh, my goodness. You know what? The Olympics, 16 days of, you know, weeping uncontrollably every time somebody won a medal.
I know.
Because, like, there's such a story, and there's such a fight, and there's such dedication behind every single one.
Dedication, years and years and years of dedication, and daily endurance, and daily competing with their own best records.
I know.
So, what were some of your favorite moments? I had so many, but I had about three top ones.
Well, you know, I mean, I think the world was captivated between, you know, the bromance between Usain Bolt and Andre DeGrasse.
The name Bolt, okay? Yeah. Like, is that ironic or what?
I know, because he is.
It's like lightning.
He's as fast
as I couldn't believe that's his last name, Bolt.
I know. He is an amazing athlete. But you know what I loved about him? Because he said everybody is trying to get him to do commercials and to, you know, endorsements and everything. And he said, if you want to film a commercial with me, you have to come to Jamaica. My people need the money and the work.
Perfectly said.
And companies are going.
Good for him.
Yeah, I thought that was a wonderful use of his, you know, celebrity.
But I watched him.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Magnificent.
Yeah. And then there was the great story between the Eatons, the husband and wife that are... she's a heptathlete and he's a decathlete. Okay. And he was supporting her when she was competing, and he had the Canada hat on. She's from Canada and he's from the U.S. Mm. And he had the Canada hat on, and he had such backlash.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe it. And then he said, I'm supporting my wife.
Of course. What's
and he
wrong
said,
with that?
And she'll be very happy to wear the U.S. hat when I... you know, compete next week.
I thought that was, he was right on.
Yeah.
Wouldn't you support your wife or your husband if you were the other person?
Exactly.
I thought Penny.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, let's get her name out here.
Oleksiak.
Penny Oleksiak was out of nowhere. They didn't think she was even going to be on the radar.
16.
Out comes this fairly focused 16-year-old from Toronto, 6'1" of... modesty. Mm. Like, she wasn't one that was boastful. Her brother actually plays for the Dallas Stars, Jamie. He's an NHLer.
Wow.
So they've got two major stars in the family.
Goodness.
And he's way older than her, but he said he went to support her nonetheless because his camps are going to be starting up pretty soon.
Yeah. She was amazing.
Yes. And she took four gold. She took one gold, one gold, one silver, and two bronze.
That's right. Yeah.
And she, like, carried the torch for Canada.
No.
Can you imagine being 16 years old leading the way for Canada?
No. And, I can't. I was still trying to figure out what, you know, shoes I was going to wear.
And the soccer game melted my heart that the Brazilians were all tuned in.
Wasn't that amazing?
They took such a defeat, right, from the 7-1 loss back at the World Cup games in 2014.
Yeah.
And to come back and have Neymar shoot that penalty shot and win over Germany 5-4, I thought, wahoo.
I know.
I was so excited for him, and he fell to the ground,
and
he blessed himself, and then all the fans, there were thousands, I think 72,000 watching at the stadium that day. They were all yelling, champions, champions. And did you see the poverty they were showing on CNN and those places?
I did.
Little people with their TV screens about this big, just cheering for all they were worth, and their little families huddled
pride.
In one room.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, they have it. That's a very poverty-stricken country.
Oh, my
Beautiful.
Goodness, Yeah.
Brazil
amazing,
itself is just out of this world, they say, Rio. I've never been there.
No, me either. But amazing to see the pride behind it and, you know, the cheer. Yes. But you know what I found really amazing was the refugee team.
Yes.
There was 10 Olympic athletes from a variety of countries, and they competed under the Olympic flag, and it was the first time in history that there was a refugee team to represent 60 million refugees.
That's pretty incredible. That would be definitely a highlight for the
event. It was amazing. And one of the swimmers, her story was out there quite early. Mm-hmm. They were fleeing Syria. They were in a boat. The boat's motor stopped, so she and another girl got into the water and swam the boat with the other refugees to shore.
Jeez.
Yeah, she saved them.
So there you go. That's a huge story.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
Well, and that's what I love about the Olympics is that it brings out, you know, so many of these incredible stories, and you get to share in their lives and, you know, and watch them compete at the highest level in the world.
And I'm just in awe about their fitness. Like, I'm just it's incredulous, really.
As I eat another cheeseburger.
I know. As I sit there with my chip and dip, I'm thinking, how many abs can a person, you know, demonstrate? It's incredible. And their strength and their women's legs and the power of the men. And it's just incredibly
Well, and the women, that Canada came in top 10 this time for medal count, which is amazing. 22 medals.
I am so proud of Canada.
22 medals. They were hoping for a top 12, so they did even better than they thought. And the women, that was the the bulk of the medals came from the women.
So there were 306 medals given out in the Olympics,
yes,
and about 11,544 people competing, right?
That's amazing.
That is. That's an astounding amount of athletes.
That's amazing.
And over a two-week duration.
Yeah.
Wow.
And
no,
then they start the Paralympic
it.
Games in a couple weeks.
Good. I'll be in tune. Yeah. What about, like a touchy subject, but a real, we won't use the word on air, but I have some form. Ryan Lochte. What'd you think about that whole scandal?
I'm speechless almost.
That whole scenario was mind-blowing. I believed it at first, didn't you?
Well, of course, and it was such a shock, you know, to hear that he and his teammate, three of his teammates, had been, you know, robbed at gunpoint. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it was, you know, you felt so terrible that was the thing that people were going to remember, that, you
yes.
know, that there was a violent act and, you know, and how scary it must have been. And then...
He was the spokesman, though, correct, Veronique?
Yeah.
He was the one that did all of the telling of the tale, didn't he? Or did the other three?
They all talked.
A little bit of it.
But, I mean, of course, he's most well-known,
well, he's
right?
32 years old, and, yeah. and, you know, a role model he should have been for those three younger swimmers.
Yeah.
He's quite a bit older.
Yeah.
For
and
sure.
So then it came out that yeah. that it hadn't, in fact, happened.
Not like he's, no.
You know, and that they actually were stopped by security mm-hmm. because they had damaged a washroom in a gas station.
Urinated in public.
Yeah. And so, you know, he's now, they've all been shipped home.
Yeah.
They've been fined. They've been, one of them's been fined for sure. You know, but like, and I know that he says, you know, they weren't thinking they were intoxicated.
Mm-hmm.
But what were you thinking?
I think his behavior sort of speaks to his past behaviors. He's been known to be very, very cocky.
Mm.
I mean, what does he have, 12 gold medals?
Yeah.
And that's wonderful. But you can be very powerful and mm-hmm. very prestigious and very out there in a very beautiful manner, which he's not.
Yeah.
He's been known to be very cocky in public. He's had altercations before. He's done urination in public before.
My
he's
goodness.
Had trespass violations against
the,
him.
Why is that the thing you pick to do?
Because I think...
Like, why would somebody
one,
pick to do that?
He thinks he's very wonderful, which he is in the way of sports, but so are how many more, okay?
Yeah.
Thousands. But because he's so handsome and because he goes out with a Playboy model and because he's had endorsement after endorsement and very in the happening scene, he thinks he's entitled,
yeah.
I believe, to act in whatever way he wants to. And unfortunately, he very much let down himself,
yeah.
his fellow teammate, mm-hmm. USA team,
mm-hmm.
his parents mm-hmm. or mom, I think he's, yeah. I think she's a single mom, mm-hmm. pretty sure, and his family and himself. He's really embarrassed himself.
Incredible. I, you know what, and part of that comes from, I think, you know, when you throw someone into the spotlight, like he's been in, like, so many, like Penny Oleksiak, you have to worry mm-hmm. now that at 16 years old, she is known around the world, you know, and so
younger.
They talked about, I was watching one of the broadcasts last night, they talked about creating that bubble around her to try and protect her, because
mm-hmm.
I think when you get thrown into that kind of lifestyle all of a sudden unexpectedly, you know,
you either
have the support and the internal fortitude to be able to deal with it, or you don't.
Oh, you fall to the wolves.
Yeah. And I think, you know, and not knowing, of course, not knowing Ryan Lochte at all, but
mm-hmm.
you know, that maybe with all of that fame and fortune that came from being a world class athlete,
mm-hmm.
that it's kind of, you know, he's gone the other way.
Yeah. Well, look at Michael Phelps, had his mm-hmm. bouts of
yeah.
badness too, right?
Yeah, yeah.
He had two DUI charges in
yeah.
the past. Now he's married, he's grown up, he's
yeah.
matured.
Got a child.
Whereas when you look at Ryan Lochte, he's not maturing in the way you
no.
would expect a man of 32 years old, which has
exactly.
which has had so many achievements to settle yeah. down finally.
Well, he's not a child.
Mm.
Yeah.
No, he's not. But anyway, so do you think he should be suspended or reprimanded in some other way? His like swimming ban made on him, or
I think, you know, the actions weren't in the pool. So for me, I think that the repercussions shouldn't be in the pool either.
That's a good thought.
I think that if he, you know, his actions were outside, so just whatever repercussions a normal person would have,
mm-hmm.
so whether it's fined or, you know, jail time or whatever it is, I think those should apply to him.
Okay.
I don't think that they, you know, should apply to, I don't think
that
he should lose his medals or you know,
okay.
or be banned from swimming.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that there then should be like some imposed, you know, counseling or something.
Do you know what I think he should do? He should talk to upcoming athletes for the
mm-hmm.
next games, 2020 Tokyo Games.
Mm-hmm.
And he should be their role model and say, this is what I've learned in a big way.
Yeah.
The mistakes I made were huge.
Yeah.
I acted out of control. This is what happens when you get drunk,
yeah.
when you're showing off, when you're da-da-da-da. And be a role model for young
yeah.
competitors for the future.
I think
and
that's
go
a great
classroom
idea.
To classroom or public forums and do that, at least do that much.
Yep, I think that's a great idea. Because I think, you know, he has an opportunity to influence
mm.
other people, and he needs to use that in a good way. Yeah. Right now, he's using his powers for evil, which is not good.
No,
so he needs, you know, something needs to happen. There needs to be some consequences,
definitely,
to what he's done.
We will see what they do to him.
But who knows? I don't think it should be
no,
pool
related. To the pool.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
And so the tragically hip.
Oh,
what a
goodness.
Poignant moment in history.
Yeah.
Right. That they
Saturday
videoed
night.
That all around the live streamed it around.
Yep.
Across
Canada.
How many people would have seen
that? They say 1/3 of Canadians watched the final concert. So
a little over
11 million on Saturday night.
I'm so proud for them.
And they went longer than they anticipated. It was on CBC, of course. Mm-hmm. And they went longer than anticipated. They started at 9 o'clock and they finished at about 20 after 11.
Wow, what a performance.
They did, I think, 3 encores.
A dear man terminally ill with that brain tumor.
Can't even imagine.
You know, it's mind-blowing, his braveness.
Yeah, I agree.
And Eddie Vedder, the front man for Pearl Jam, did a video, and it was very wonderful, just saying, you know, he's so brave, Gord Downie, and I'm so proud of him, and I've spent time with him, and soldier on, and we're behind you. And he was at his own concert in Chicago at the time, Pearl Jam was, and took time out to go to the mic and give honor to Gord Downie, how so many people revere.
Oh, well, it's amazing. Like, I mean, his gifts in, you know, they call him a poet, and in writing, he's written so many of the songs that we grew up with. And I remember for me, the Tragically Hip were really big around first year university, and, you know, listening to their songs over and over and over and over again. And Fiddler's Green was my favorite song.
So that's your reminder of college, mine, Supertramp. We all have an album that we go back to.
Isn't that amazing?
And Tragically Hip was yours.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, that was first year university for sure. But we're almost out of time now.
Are we?
Yeah, we've got a great show coming up today.
We certainly do.
But we just, you know, there was so much going on the weekend. I just want to mention what happened over the weekend. So the Scottish, Miramichi Scottish Festival happened, and they had the Fockabers from Scotland that came and played. And the first festival happened in 1990 here in Miramichi.
Wow.
Incredible.
1990.
And then the Air Show Atlantic.
Mm.
The Snowbirds were fantastic.
That, the big heart in the sky.
Yes, and the tribute to the Tragically Hip, of course, by the Snowbirds.
I commend those guys.
I know.
And speaking of powerful, and they brought in hundreds and hundreds of spectators.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it
and
was
I was
packed.
Amazed by it.
Yeah, it was a packed weekend. And so, you know, really, there's, and of course, the Eskenopenage First Nations
powwow.
So really, there was no excuse to be bored this weekend.
No, I had a wedding party to go to.
Yes, of course
a
you did.
A post-wedding party for my cousin's daughter, and that was a beautiful event. So.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It was a great weekend.
There's never nothing to do here.
No.
So we're pretty excited about the show we have coming up.
Yeah.
We have many guests today.
Yes,
many
we do.
Guests today. So we're looking forward to that. And of course, we'll look forward to Audrey coming back to us next week. But she's kind of, you know, hanging with
tied
the kidlets today.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, hanging with the kidlets today.
Yes.
So now, if you haven't grabbed your coffee yet for the day, do that, and then come on back and visit us as we get to meet with a couple of young people who are performing in the area, and a couple of other people that are going to tell us all about some exciting news coming soon.
Yes.
So go grab a coffee, curl up on the couch, and we'll have a chat in a few minutes. Hi, and welcome back to Have a Chat. I'm Vernie Garcino, your host for today, with my fantastic co-host, Judy Loge, of course. And we are so excited to welcome to our very wonderfully made set, Jennifer Loucts and Jean Doyle from the Miramichi Senior Citizens Home.
Welcome.
So welcome.
Nice you wore black on this jury day.
Thanks for the pop of pink, Jean.
They got the memo.
She thought of us. She brought some brightness to the set. Welcome.
Welcome, ladies. We're so excited to have you both, and we're excited that you're going to tell us all about something that special that's coming up at the home. But first, we want to know all about you.
Okay. Well, I've been in the Miramichi for probably almost 5 years. Uh-huh. I came here to work for the Miramichi Regional Hospital, and then I got a call from Jean Doyle about coming to the Miramichi Seniors, and have been with them for about a year and a half. Uh-huh. I work as a recreation therapist there, and I also work with the volunteers and our rehab services. And one of the other roles is I help with fundraisers for the home.
Oh, that's a big job.
Yes.
None of those are small, I don't think.
No.
I would say I stole her. She said yes.
Yes, you don't regret that decision ever.
No, it's awesome. Yes.
And what about you, Jean? Jean Doyle, on my side.
I've been at the home actually for 28 years.
Wow.
So I started in Jennifer's position. I was the rec therapist.
Oh,
so,
I didn't know that.
And yes.
So you knew what you needed then?
I knew exactly what I needed. So, and from there, I grew into the administrator's role. So I've been in that role for 3 years. So,
okay.
A change for sure for me, because it's not as hands-on with the residents, but you're still doing the same sort of thing. Mm-hmm. Everything is about the care for the residents and what we can do to help them.
Yes.
I was going to say, though, you must miss that contact a little
bit. I do, but I still get it. I still make my rounds.
Yeah. So you have five children?
I have five children.
Oh, gosh. Wow, and grandchildren.
I'm always
too.
Amazed.
Four grandchildren.
Really?
Yes.
I'm always amazed. I have a fur baby.
And I have one just graduated, so I'm thinking, wow, people are all over the place. You have family too, Jennifer.
I do. I have two children. Yes.
Yeah. Isn't that one of them?
Yes.
Delightful. Yeah. Little girl.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
And then I also coach basketball and all those other things in the community. So, yeah, my son's a basketball
team. So you don't
team.
Have any time off either?
No, I don't. No. Always no on the go.
No. But here, we're going to have time together to share some information about the seniors' home.
So tell us, So tell us about the seniors' home. Yeah. Tell us about what you've got upcoming and kind of how that all fits.
Sure. Well, we usually do preserves in the fall with our residents. We do a lot of activities that things that they would have done in the past that they enjoy doing. So we've started doing more music events at the home as well. Even with our seniors, they'll get up and sing and whatnot. Like
Sweet.
We did a Miramichi Seniors Got Talent show. We do it around Halloween so they could dress up and they can share their talent. And so I thought, wouldn't it be nice to incorporate some sort of musical fundraiser for the home? Wow. And one of our residents, her son is Curtis Sullivan.
I've seen him.
Is a wonderful bass baritone from Toronto. Nice. And I nabbed him last summer and I said, would you be willing to do a show for us and we can incorporate some other local talent and as a fundraiser for our home? And with the idea that a lot of our outreach programs that we do in the home, we would like to expand them. And they've been around for a long time. And we thought we'd like to do more for the outreach programs.
Well, my grandmother was in the Miramichi Senior Citizens Home for a number of years, and she, you know, she was so at home there, and she of course had dementia in her later years, but I remember the outreach, like we called it school, but she went to daycare, right?
Yes.
Every day. And for her, though, we would say, okay, now, Margie, you have to get up and get ready for school. And so in her mind, that clicked. And
yes.
So she would go on the bus, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, it's so, God, I miss her. Anyway, but it's so amazing, the programs that you do have there and the interaction
care.
That you have with the seniors and, you know, and the work that you do is so important. Mm-hmm. And I know that we were so grateful.
Yes, we were.
Now, see, I got all emotional.
Don't get emotional now.
I told you today it was not one of those days.
You must find it hard not to get emotional, though. When you lose those special, you know, dear elderly people that are there, not always very old either. There are a lot of people there that aren't elderly, right?
No.
That just need a good home.
Yep.
So it's hard. You get attached.
Yeah, you do. Because we want to know their life story and who they were about and what they like to do, and we try and incorporate those things in the activities that we do at the home.
Like
so,
family. They become family.
It's important to find those little moments. Yeah. And it's those little moments that make the difference. That that little piece of quality of life for them makes your day. You know when you've done that with someone.
Mm-hmm. When you read somebody. Or,
But the music must be a particularly, because that you know, takes us, we talked about it, you know, the Tragically Hip, and that was my first year of university, right? Mm-hmm. So music must do the same thing for the residents.
Absolutely. In fact, music memory is one of our last memories that we lose. So those folks that have dementia, we try and do a lot of music with them because it's a stimulation for them.
Mm-hmm.
And for some of our residents who can't converse with us, if we sing an old song, they can actually remember the words and sing along to it.
I've really thought that.
Yes.
So if you had an old Elvis song, like when it was first, they can hear that. Could be.
Yeah. And I actually sing Elvis in the home.
And you know what? For the viewers that don't know, Jennifer, you're a beautiful singer.
Thank you.
And I've heard her
firsthand. I haven't heard her sing yet.
You made me cry singing Beautiful Mother by Jan Arden at the fundraiser for Haiti. And you're so lucky to have her here.
Oh, we are.
And
so let's
very
try
lucky. To the patients.
Yes, we do. We try and do a music interaction program once a week, and we get the shakers out and the tambourines and sing the old war songs, and everybody knows all the songs, and they sing along. And
you play guitar?
I actually play a hand drum,
a
djembe.
That's right, right.
Yeah, I play the djembe, and I sing, and have my shakers and whatnot. So.
As a shaker.
Jean, do you have your shakers?
No. She made me get up for that talent show, and I said, she put me at a keyboard, and I pretended to play, and I was like, please let me up here. Quick, guys. How long can this song last?
You were faking it on the keyboard.
Oh, yeah.
So tell us more about the concert. So
yes,
I'm going to put that up so that everybody can see it.
So it's happening Saturday, September 10th at Carrefour Beausoleil School.
Nice.
And Curtis Sullivan is our headliner. And then we also have Terry Whalen, a local musician.
We've had him on the show.
Yes.
Great guy, too.
And Jimmy Lingley, local as well.
Yes.
And Paula Tozer is from this area, but she's in Fredericton, so she'll be coming as well.
Paula Tozer. Doesn't ring a bell, but I do know Paula Tozer. Maybe it's her, I just didn't know she could sing.
There you go.
Yes. Yeah. So we're, and the Villagers.
Okay, you're part of the Villagers.
I am, yes.
Right.
Yeah, so we're excited to be a part of this.
Curtis Sullivan's fantastic. So for anyone that, you know, is thinking about it, I insist that you go.
Yes.
So tickets are $20.
Tickets are $20, and we have a wine and cheese, and we'll have an art display. And the art display is actually work that the seniors have been doing over the year.
Oh, really?
So some of them have done some painting, some of them have done... we just did a CD craft where we took old CDs and painted them and did etch sketchings on them. And so
you teach art.
Well,
a little bit of everything.
There's a talented bunch here. Yeah. So, well, I have some great coworkers, so, and they help out with those things. So, and lots of volunteers. We're always looking for volunteers at the home. But we want to display some of the work that these seniors have been doing, because a lot of them have done art in the past, and we want to feature some of their work as well. So,
So tell us a little bit about, so where can you get the tickets?
You can get the tickets at the Knappen Bakery, Country Charm Bakery, Town Hill Jewelers. You can get them at the Miramichi Senior Citizens Home, and as well at Mill Cold Coffee.
Okay.
So those wonderful businesses have offered to make those tickets available at their businesses. So the tickets are available right now. We also have been trying to do some community events where we sell tickets at Deals for You and the Superstore and whatnot, so we've certainly made people aware of the concert there.
Yes.
We have posters to put up anywhere that anyone would like to put them up in their business.
Good.
And tickets are $20, and the doors open at 6 for the wine and cheese.
Nice.
And the concert will start at 7. It'll probably be about an hour and a half. And we do have an auction as well. We're hoping to do a Chinese auction.
Full night.
Yes, it'll be great. Lots of businesses have donated to that, so we're really appreciative of any help with that.
That's one of the things about the area here particularly, is that, you know, businesses donate day after day after day after day, and products and time and money. It's really amazing in a community.
They keep giving.
Yeah, in a community this size and the region in general, because you see it all over the place, the amount that businesses give back.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and we're so thankful for that, because organizations like you know like yours and every other one that we've belonged to, you know, really benefit from that.
So you two planned this together. You thought of this concert, which is a great time of year to have, September 10th. The kids are back in school.
Yes.
Everyone's gone back to university as well. So whose little baby was this now? Had you been thinking about this auction and art with the...
is Jennifer's baby.
Oh, it is your baby.
That music came through with her.
All right.
Yeah. I had to sell it to Jean.
She did. Yeah. Just because I'm not as musical, and we've always done little things, but we've never really gone back out in the community and done something this big.
Fantastic.
So Jennifer said, we've got to try. We've just got to do this.
A nice fundraiser.
And it'll be a nice fundraiser. And it's also for community awareness. Like, sometimes the community doesn't understand the outreach programs that we actually have. They don't always remember that we are the people with Meals on Wheels, Lifeline, the adult day program that you talked about earlier. Those programs are really unique to our area.
Yes.
And we're lucky because we actually have a few things in those programs that other places don't have. The fact that the bus goes out and picks people up.
Yes. Right to their home.
Yeah.
And that was such a huge help for us with Grandma. Because, you know, we were all working. Mom and I were working. Yeah. I was living here full time at the time, and Mom and I was working in Rexton. So it was a great help to us that you know, that they would come and get Grandma and go to school.
There's so many families that hear that. There's so many families, they say, what a great thing to know that they can get dressed in the morning, have activity at the, you know, senior citizens home.
And the mental stimulation, right? Because you know, she was so social. My
socialization is such a big part of that.
Yeah, exactly. So really to be able to do that, you know, in that particular program. So tell us a little bit about Meals on Wheels.
Meals on Wheels, what happens is we provide a nutritious meal at lunchtime to people out in the community, and what happens is we have volunteers that come and pick them up.
Really?
Yes.
And deliver them right to their house.
Okay.
And for some people, that's the only time they'll see anyone all day.
Oh, wow.
So, I mean, it's such an important program. It allows people to stay home.
Mm-hmm. When, and you've had volunteers, the same volunteers for many years, haven't you? A lot of them.
That program's been, I think, from 1979. Wow. So it tells you how long these.
Yes. These I wasn't.
I was a candy striper at that home when I was 12.
Oh wow!
And I remember this one older man. He'd chase me around. He'd say, "Give me a KISS." Give me a KISS. I used to run down the hall because I was only 12, and I didn't want to kiss him. But I'll never forget that moment. And I won't give his name on air because one of his long, you know, lasting relatives might be watching. But he was a pet. Yeah, so it's fun.
Tell us a little bit about Lifeline.
Lifeline program, it's just something that protects people in their home, so that when they're home, if they're staying at home alone, especially at night, and let's say they had a fall, mm-hmm. then they can push their button and they can actually talk. You can hear someone else, like they'll come right over and talk to them and say, "Are you okay?"
Uh-huh.
And we have responders that can go to the house and they have a key, they can get in, and then they can help the person.
It's a wonderful thing.
It is. And it's saved many, many people. Well, just because if you're stuck on the floor and you can't get up and you mm-hmm. can't reach the phone, you might be there for days.
Well, it happened to my neighbor, my elderly neighbor. Mm-hmm. She's now in a seniors home, moved because her family's away in Moncton, so she's at a home in Moncton. But one day I had her key, she gave me her key, and the Lifeline called. She fell. So over I went, and there she was on the floor, curled all up and injured.
Yeah.
And so, you know, thankfully that's in place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wonderful.
So the funds that you raise then through this fundraiser mm-hmm. and other things are going to go to help those programs stay in place.
Yes.
We're hoping to actually expand our day program room.
Okay.
We want to make it bigger. It only holds 15 clients right now, and we feel that that's not enough. Mm-hmm. And so there's times when we get to a limit and then we just have to take names on a waiting list.
Yes.
So we think it would be so nice if we could expand that room and, you know, help more people in the community.
Because we're seeing more and more that people with dementia, Alzheimer's, that they can stay home longer because they have somewhere to go during the day.
Yes.
So it's wonderful that we don't have to, you know, go to the hospital, or they don't have to go to the home permanently. They can come to our day program and the families find it easier to manage them at home when they have something to go to during the day.
Yes, for sure.
So it's such a wonderful program to offer that need for the in the community. And
it's also that if people go to the programs and then they end up in the nursing home, they're actually familiar with the environment.
Right.
So it helps them when they come in. It's just like
familiarization.
Well
right?
It's just like another day in the program.
Exactly. Except they become really adjust to it.
Well, they know all the staff. Mm-hmm. They know the routine. Mm-hmm. So it just makes it easier to adjust.
That's right. Yeah.
So talk to us a little bit about the art that's going to be on display. So how did that idea come about, and have they been working on it all year? Just walk us through it.
We had a resident, and he passed away in the last couple of months, but he was a wonderful artist. He did painting and whatnot. And when I came on board a year and a half ago, I thought, wouldn't it be nice to try and find out who the artists are in our midst and give them an outlet for their art and keep them creative? Because a lot of them, even working with their hands, it helps even if they have arthritis and whatnot. They're working on their range of motion and things like that. So there's always a purpose to everything we do.
Mm-hmm.
But so we don't worry about the outcome. If the art, it's all art is subjective. So we get them involved in those kinds of pieces. And
great
so we
idea.
Have paintings.
Mine
would
be terrible.
And,
no.
It's the process. It's never the outcome. It's the process of actually doing something like that. And a lot of our ladies and gentlemen, they get working with their hands, and they really, it reminds them of the past, or it's a favorite hobby that they've been able to take up again. So even building little bird houses or things like that, or doing some painting, or we have stained glass window designs that they've done, and the CD art and different things. So
I wonder how jewelry would go, beading type things.
Well, yeah, we've tried to do that before. I have an idea for craft using newspaper and doing newspaper necklaces. So that's kind of on the forefront for another craft. We're right in the midst of preserves right now. We're doing Lady Ashburn pickles bread and butter pickles.
Bread and butter pickles are my favorite.
They love preserves. Yeah. We're doing beets today, so the home is filled with the smell
I
of beets.
I love beets.
Yes.
And they're good for you too.
Beets don't float my boat.
But I wasn't thinking of the arthritic type people working with their hands and doing the art, which, you know, of course, rehabilitation, that's incorporated into the program, so I love the idea.
That's fantastic.
I'm gonna. Well, okay. So we have to go to that Carrefour Beau Soleil.
I know. Yeah. Let's just reiterate all this so that in case somebody missed it at the top of the show.
So Saturday, September 10th,
an evening of music.
Yes, an evening of music starts at 6 o'clock. Doors will open. You can buy tickets at the door as well, but if you buy them ahead. It's great to buy them ahead at those different locations.
It'll help you with the planning.
Yes, but we're planning for, I think there's 350 seats in the auditorium, so we're hope to sell as many tickets as we can. And there's a wine and cheese, and we also have the art display, Chinese auction, and the concert, which will be awesome.
Could I make a little request?
Yes.
Could you sing a song that night?
I possibly can.
Jennifer, you have to.
Well, I would love to. It's hard to be an organizer and an entertainer at the same time, but
I'm just sure one we song.
Can, yeah, we could
I'm
probably
sure we
fit
can
one.
Twist her arm.
Oh, we have to do that.
Well, now I have to hear you sing.
It's an incredible voice.
So in our last minute, I just want to make sure that everybody knows. So tickets are $20.
Yes.
They are available at Knapp & Bakery, Country Charm, and Miramichi Senior Citizens Home, Town Hill Jeweler, and Mill Cove Coffee.
Yes.
And we want to make sure that everybody goes out because there's going to be Terry Whalen, who is a great friend of our show.
He's a great guy. Yes.
Jimmy Lingley, The Villagers, and Paula Tozer.
And Jennifer Loucts.
That we've now bullied into doing our bidding on stage.
Yeah, she has to.
We're good.
So the doors open at 6 o'clock, right on, and the concert at 7.
So we want to thank you both for coming today
and for talking about the home, of course, and the fundraiser to come.
Yeah. But we want to make sure that everybody out there doesn't go too far. We have two great performers coming up right after the break. So freshen up your coffee, cuddle up on the couch, and we'll see you back in a couple of minutes. Hi, and welcome back to Have a Chat. We had a fantastic segment with Jennifer Loucts and Jean Doyle from the Miramichi Senior Citizens Home. But now we are so excited to welcome Jack Wilson and Katherine Wilson with us here on the set. So welcome to you both.
Brother and sister team.
Fantastic performers. We're all excited to have you both.
Good looking kids. I feel old all of a sudden.
I know. That's what happens every time we do this.
But the viewers love to have children on the show. Yeah. It just makes them realize that, you know, kids have so much to offer this world.
We have so much
local talent. Mm-hmm. A young age.
So Jack, tell us a little bit about you.
I'm 11 years old.
Holy cow.
And I'm going into middle school.
Already.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
Are you nervous?
I'm excited, but I'm nervous.
Yeah.
It's amazing to leave your old school, right?
Yeah.
This?
Yeah.
For sure.
And so do you sing?
Yes, I sing.
And what else do you do?
I play sports. I play baseball and hockey. Last year for hockey, I played on the AA team.
All right.
And we won the provincials.
You did?
Yeah.
Wow. How exciting is that? Do you have a main position you played in hockey always?
I play left wing.
Okay. And what about baseball?
Baseball, we're doing very well this year. We finished first in the league.
Holy cow.
Superstar.
And we're going into provincials in 2 weeks.
How exciting is that?
He's more coordinated than we are.
He's amazing to do all of that and sing.
I know.
And academically, I'm sure you're an achiever in that department, too.
Yeah, and I run.
You run, too?
Yeah, I do road races. I do 5 kilometer races.
5 kilometer races.
Yeah. One day, maybe you'll be in the Olympics.
I know.
Yeah.
Then you we can say we knew him when.
I know we knew him when.
Katherine, you tell us a little bit about
Katherine.
You.
I'm 8 years old, and going into French immersion, and I run, and I play soccer, and I play hockey and basketball. And,
holy cow!
And now, cross country starting up in school, so I'm going to be in that too.
What grade are you going into?
And I sing.
And I know you sing. You're a beautiful little singer.
What's your
like
favorite
Jack.
Thing, sports or singing? You're not sure? I don't know what I'd like better either.
I have neither skill, so me either.
If I was good at all of those things, I don't know if I could pick one.
But your parents must be extremely busy. They're good parents, so to take you to all those events.
Yeah.
Have you not? Didn't you play hockey this morning already?
Yeah.
It was a camp tryout type
thing? Yeah.
Wow.
So Jack, tell us a little bit. How did you get interested in music?
Well, my first week of kindergarten.
He's going way back now.
Yes.
Yeah. my music teacher, Emily Cummo, Mrs. Cummo, she realized that I had a gift, so she told my parents, and She recommended me to go see Mr. Bunnell.
Oh, he's a wonderful man.
Yeah.
We all know David Bunnell.
Yeah.
He's an extremely vital person in our music setting here. Yeah.
So you know what? You probably don't remember, but a couple of years ago, I was part of the music festival, and I was the chair of the music festival, and I got to see you perform, and I thought that was one of the neatest things I had ever seen.
I remember
you from a couple of years ago.
Yes. I think I'm one for putting people on the spot. I'm going to do it now. We won't get Vierney today, but I would like to ask you before we finish off the discussion with you and Katherine, if you would just stand up, and since we did so well as a nation in the Olympics and won all of those gold medals, would you do us the honor of showing patriotism and singing our national anthem?
Yeah, sure.
All right.
There you go.
So you just stand right up there, Jack.
Keep back the chair right up.
And this is a cappella, so you know we know that there's no instruments for people to.
We just need your voice.
Yep,
you stand right up. There we go.
And I'll just say on the count of three, and we'll just stand here proudly, and you take O Canada away. So on the count of three. One, two, three.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
I got chills.
I know.
That was amazing. And what a beautiful rendition of O Canada that was, Jack.
Thank you. My goodness. No wonder your teacher said you were so talented.
Yes.
No wonder. And I know Mrs. Como really well because she's been on the music festival committee with me.
Yes.
And she does so much work with the young people.
I know she does. And you've been star of the festival at one point, haven't you? Have you ever been the star, the vocal star of the festival?
Yeah.
Was it recently?
It was 2 years ago.
2 years ago? So you were only, how old are you now?
I am 11.
Imagine being a star at that age.
I can't even imagine being a star at my age. I'm old.
And Katherine, what do you like to sing, honey? What are some of your favorite types of music to sing? Songs that you've sung?
Like in the music festival?
Yeah, anytime, like in public.
I sang Red River Valley.
Oh.
In the folk song festival.
Right.
And I sang Annie Maybe and musical theater, and I sing for Christmas. I sing When Christmas Comes to Town.
That would be beautiful.
Now, how did you get interested in music?
Jack.
So he is a good big brother. Like, you would never fight. No.
Did you fight with your brother?
We had wrestling matches, WWF.
I don't have any brothers or sisters.
So you can fight with me?
Yeah.
But you look after your sister, I bet. You try to role model for her as well, because she's only that much, you know, a few years younger than you.
Yeah.
So do you sing together? Like, do you do duets?
We did it once with the Villagers.
The Villagers, who Jennifer was a part of, that was just on our show. Jennifer Loucts is one of the Villagers.
Yeah.
Now, what was your favorite concert to sing in?
Me?
Yeah.
It was probably at the Cute Awards when I sang New York, New York, and I got a standing ovation.
Did you? Really? That's a good one. See, now Judy can sing.
Yeah, but no, I can't, but I can groove. So what did you have to wear for that? Some kind of New York fashion?
Yeah, I had to wear a suit and a top hat.
You look great in a suit, though.
Thanks.
But you'd rather be in a hockey uniform, probably, wouldn't you?
No.
No? You're quite happy in a suit.
Yeah.
So what's your favorite age group to perform at? Like, do you like performing for your school with your peers, or do you prefer an older audience?
I like I like both.
Okay.
I like both.
Both.
Now, somebody told me that you got to sing in the mayor's Christmas concert.
Yeah.
Yeah? How'd you like that?
It was really fun.
Yeah?
Yes.
What's your favorite Christmas song to sing?
Probably It's Beginning to Look a Lot Like Christmas.
Mm. As long as it's not beginning to look a lot like snow, we can handle the Christmas part, right?
But yeah, we talked about that. We don't want any snow this year.
No. So you're both just recently in the Folksong Festival.
Yep.
The youngest by miles, right? You would be the youngest participating for sure.
Well, there was a lot of children in our age.
Yeah, there were?
Yeah.
But weren't you the featured guest, Jack?
Yeah.
The star
kind
of thing.
Yeah.
And along with your sister, they're looking so beautiful on the stage. You got to sing as well.
Thank you.
Aw. I saw pictures of them when I was on travel, and I had to miss the Folksong Festival.
Yeah.
But I saw your pictures in the paper.
Yeah.
You look pretty darn good.
They were pretty cool. They were pretty cool. Yeah. So talk about a little bit, now, how did you get to meet Susan Butler?
Well, at one of Mr. Bunnell's concerts, I sang Ave Maria.
Oh, my favorite.
Wow.
And she,
that's a tough song.
Yeah. And she came over to me afterwards, and she said, how would you like to sing at one of my fundraisers?
Aww.
And I said, I would love that.
Yes.
So next year, this year it was 59 years they've been having the Folksong Festival.
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing. And you got to be one of the performers this year. Very cool.
And Kathy, too, so you'll be there in years to come at that Folksong Festival, right? Do you like to practice? How many hours in a day would you practice? Do you have a set time that you do your voice lessons?
No.
No? What about your time with Mr. Bunnell? Your singing
usually lessons? An hour and a half.
Mm.
Now, do you play any instruments, Jack?
I used to play the piano, and that was too much work.
And a hockey stick instead, right?
Yeah. And I'm going to be playing guitar here soon.
You are.
Love the guitar.
What about you, Catherine?
I don't play any instruments, but I think next year I'm gonna start the piano.
Good. Oh, so love Jack on guitar and you on piano.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah. Musical family. Your mom sings, doesn't she?
She plays the guitar.
She's very gifted, and she's a school teacher as well.
Yeah.
So she's a busy lady with traveling all around with you two kids and all of your activities.
Yeah.
So who do you look up to? Who's your favorite singer at the moment, Jack?
Me?
If you could pick anybody that you look up to as a singer.
As a singer.
You know, a star maybe, or an older singer, somebody that you really love.
Mommy.
Your mom?
That's a good answer.
That made me cry again.
I know.
I thought you were going to say Justin Bieber.
No.
Nah, not a fan. Don't like him.
I used to, but.
Yeah. His image is going a little bit shady now, right? Yeah. Catherine, who do you love as a singer? What female?
Jack.
Jack! That's a family affair.
See, such great answers. Such great answers.
Incredible.
I know.
Have people ever asked you for autographs yet?
No.
Okay, right on my head. I want an autograph.
Yeah, but then I can't auction it off.
Yeah, but it'll make sure I wonder who Jack is. So when I get home and I have Jack on my hand, I'm going to show my husband.
But see, I want to make some extra money, so now I can't auction off your hand.
Well, there, and Catherine, if I could reach you, I'd get over to you, too, because, your first autograph on my hand.
There you go.
I have a chat.
Yeah, so when you're rich and famous,
yes,
you can tell everybody that you gave your first autograph on the TV.
Yeah.
So what would you think that you'd like to talk about now in your music career? Where do you see yourself 10 years from now? What would you like to be doing?
What do you want
to
do?
In your musical future?
I would just like performing.
Want to keep it up?
Yeah, I want to keep it up.
And get better and train better.
Yeah.
Well, that was just superb, all Canada.
I know.
You going to stick to music too, Catherine?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So do you get nervous when you're up on stage in front of all those people?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
More nervous when it's in front of a smaller crowd.
Don't you, Veronique? Yeah.
Yeah, you're probably right.
If there were 10 people in the room and we had to stand in front and give a speech or sing in front, they're all staring at you, right? But if you're in a big crowd, it's just a bunch of bodies out there.
Yeah.
So you can kind of look past them.
Yeah.
And not focus on those people sitting right in front glaring at you or
looking
at you.
It's easier.
That's right.
Yeah.
So what's your type? What does Mr. Bunnell say your voice is? There's certain, baritone and there's... I don't know all the music lingo, but
I'm not smart enough
your
with
range
that stuff.
Of music, your tone. Is there a certain there's baritone and
tenor?
For me,
tenor.
I don't know.
No, you're working on it. You're working on a certain type.
Now, so Mr. Bunnell plays the piano, right?
Yeah.
And so he's teaching you how to sing.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. And he accompanies you for just about everything?
Yep.
He's a pretty gifted musician,
yeah,
eh?
Yeah, he plays
in our church sometimes.
He taught my younger sister music, and she's now a grown adult and lives in Toronto.
Really?
And yeah. She was acting all over Canada.
Yeah, Jennifer, and she was the star of the music festival when she was 10 years old.
Really?
I think it was 10. 10 years old.
Yeah.
Yes, she was so proud coming with us. So you got a trophy?
No, I didn't get a trophy.
No, but in the music festival, you got money?
Yeah, I got it.
He got a prize.
Cash is good.
Yeah.
So now, if you could say something to Mr. Bunnell on the air, what would it be?
I would say thank you for all your hard work. We really appreciate it.
Mm-hmm.
And I look forward to coming back next year.
And Katherine, do you take your lessons from Mr. Bunnell too?
Yeah.
Yeah. And he's working hard with you too, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
He's a very patient man, isn't he?
Yeah.
And he brings out the best skills. He works until he figures you're reaching your best that you can possibly be. He doesn't give up easy.
No.
Patient.
So are you gonna be in the music festival this year coming?
Yeah.
Yeah? Do you have a kind of a song that you think you might like to try this year? Have you figured that out yet?
No, I haven't.
No, I. You got lots of time.
Do you like competition?
Yes.
Like, do you like to prove that you're the best at your, no, really, the best.
Yeah.
The best. You like that?
Yeah.
Are you competitive in sports as well?
Yes.
And music?
Yeah. Does it make you nervous?
No.
Do you like to be your best and compete?
Yeah.
Katherine?
Yeah.
To know that you can prove yourself to be the top-notch gal out there singing?
Uh-huh.
In everything you do? You try your hardest to beat the
other
person?
Yeah.
That's good, though.
Now, Katherine, did you say that you play hockey?
Yeah.
What position do you play? You're just starting out.
Well, I did last year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Now I'm moving up to a different level
of
hockey.
Wow. So young, Veronique, right?
I know. I see, now I'm not very good on skates at all.
No?
No, not at all. I was always afraid of the ice.
Okay, I did competitive figure skating.
Put me on skis and I can bomb down a hill quicker than a bunny rabbit. But put me on skates and I'm terrified.
It's all right. He can teach you.
I know. I think that will probably get you to do that.
But with what you're doing, you have to have a certain level of confidence to perform. So, what's your definition of confident in general? If I said, what is confident to you, Jack, what would you say?
It would be just being...
Getting up there and doing your best.
Yeah.
Which is exactly what you do every time,
just
right?
Trying your best.
Block out everybody else and give it all you've got.
Yeah.
Right, you're confident, Katherine. Do you like to fashion up for your performances? Like, do your hair a certain way?
Yeah.
Does your mommy do your hair?
Yeah.
Yeah, my
it's
mom
long.
Did too. I know.
And you have to dress up for all of these events? For the Billy Jews performance and your recitals. You have to wear a suit, Jack, and you have to wear a dress?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just about out of time. It's hard to believe, but you know what? We were so proud of you guys, and especially Jack for getting up and singing O Canada, and Katherine for being able to talk about what you want to do and all the new things that you're going to get excited about doing this year.
And what you're going to be when you grow up. What do you want to be when your careers take off down the road?
I would like to be an NHL player.
Then you will be. That's confidence. Katherine, what do you think you'd like to be?
I have two things I want to be.
Okay. What?
One thing, I want to be a doctor.
Oh, cool.
What type of a doctor?
One.
Like a family doctor?
Yeah.
A family doctor. You see everybody. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Or?
And what's the other one?
Be one of Katy Perry's dancers.
Why not a co-singer?
I love it.
Katy Perry, one of her backup dancers.
Yep.
She'd probably love to have you.
I think so.
Thank you.
And maybe you could throw a song in there with her.
Well, we want to thank both of you for coming on today. You guys were amazing.
They are amazing.
We can't wait to see what you're going to do next.
My autograph.
I know.
I can't give the last name. It's a mystery.
I can't auction it off, though. That's not good.
I'll wave my hand to everybody.
Okay.
I got Jack Wilson's autograph today and have a chat.
Yeah.
Now, we want to make sure that everybody checks us out on Facebook. Of course, we'll be up on YouTube in a couple of days, so we don't want you to miss that. And if you haven't yet gotten to check out Jack and Katherine, be sure to do that at the next festival coming around. Thank you so much for joining us today. We had a very full show and a lot of fun. Don't forget to join us next week, and we'll see you again.
Thank you.